is essentially that once you do bhakti and the devotion, slowly, slowly your bhakti increases, and through the scriptures, pramane, sadacharya, abhyas, nirantam, right? Nirantram, we do abhyas of bhakti and then we develop some jnana. Then what happens is bodhyatmanam, yani atma ka anubhav hota hai, we realize our self consciousness and bhaktim uttam bhaktim labhet. So uttam, this is uttam bhakti ka labh hota hai. So that's how we get the uttam bhakti, which is the prem bhakti. So this is what Lord Govind is explaining to Lord Brahma, that when you do this srishti rachana, make sure that the prem bhakti is explained to all the jivas for the benefit of all the jivas like us. So we'll start from the shlok 60 today. Yashah sreshkaram nasti yaya nirvati mapnuyat ya sadhyati mame bhaktim tameva sadhye. So what Lord Krishna is saying, is these preliminary practices of devotion, sadhana bhakti, are conducive to the realization of loving devotion. Loving devotion, prem bhakti, then whom there is no superior well-being. So there is nothing superior to that. Who goes hand in hand with the attainment of the exclusive state of supreme bliss, and who can lead to myself. So what can lead to myself is prem bhakti. So if you look at the shloka again, is yashah shreyash karam nasti. Yani jo prem bhakti Lord Krishna is explaining, there is nothing which is shreya than that. There is nothing superior to that. Yaya nirvati mapnuya. So that is Paramananda Sukh. So Paramananda Anand is achieved through prem bhakti. There is nothing superior to that. And not only that, ya sadhyati mamev, which means it can also lead to me. How do you lead to Lord Krishna? How do you get to Lord Krishna? Is bhaktim tamev sadhyate. Jo bhakti prem karta hai, usse na to kuch shrestha hai, usse paramanand prapt hota hai, and it can also lead to Lord Krishna. Okay, and who can lead to myself? So, Reena ji padenge?
No, yeah. The jiva soul has no better well-being than loving devotion. In this is realized the final beatitude of jivas. The lotus feet of Krishna are attainable only by loving devotion. He who cultivates the preliminary devotional activities anxiously, keeping in view that realized state of devotion, can alone attain to that object of all endeavor. None else can have the same. Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna. So any comments on this?
Go ahead.
We should always have a loving devotion towards Krishna, and that is the basic thing. Once we have that, then I think we can achieve, that's what he's saying, the lotus feet of Krishna are attainable only by loving devotion. So I think not only we should have a devotion, but the devotion should be loving, it should be affection towards Krishna. It's very important.
And it says only by loving devotion.
Yep.
Like how can you attain Lord Krishna? So we can do meditation for like 1,000 hours. We can do all the sacrifices and austerity and yoga and so many things, and they're all good. They all lead us to ultimate, like if we have some jnana and bhakti, that's what, and loving devotion is something like in the previous slokas, it also mentioned, Mukesh, I think, there is that loving devotion will only come when you have a regular devotion. So slowly and slowly by our regular devotion, and then we start realizing, also gain some knowledge, and then we start realizing our consciousness, our soul, that's when the loving devotion will come. And
Yeah, you practice devotion and then you start enjoying. And when you start enjoying, you start loving, you have affection. So it's very important, like you said, we have to start, well, be devoted, start practicing it, and then develop that loving devotion. Then only we'll be able to achieve Krishna, as per this. That's very good.
Okay. Rina, you were saying something?
Yes, my question was that the second, the third line actually, he who cultivates the preliminary devotional activities, anxiously keeping in view that realized state of devotion can alone attain to the object of all endeavor. What does it mean when they say preliminary devotional activities?
Yeah, that is the regular devotional activities we are talking about. So like the satsang we are doing right now, or the chanting we are doing right now, right? So we are doing it as a regular satsang. But when you are chanting, how much close we are to Lord Krishna, let's say, right? Is our mind going across all around the world, right? Or we can actually focus on Lord Krishna's feet, or how our devotion has improved or has been enhanced. So where are we in terms of our devotion? How many, you know, like we are reading the scriptures, like we are reading Brahma Samhita now, we'll read Srimad Bhagavatam from tomorrow, most likely. We have read Bhagavad Gita. So those are the activities we are doing as part of our devotional activities. But those are really, if you really think about it, those are our preliminary devotional activities. Okay. By doing that, like as we saw in the previous shloka, yeah, I think you missed that, Rina, you too. In the previous shloka, it clearly said that when, actually, let me bring it back up because it's very, so important. Since Prabhude Jnana Bhakti Bhyam Atmanayananda Chinmayi. So Prabhude means Ujwal Hoti Hai. Jnana Bhakti Bhyam Bhyatmanaya, which means Jnana Bhakti Bhyam is Jnana or Bhakti Ke Dwara. That's a preliminary Bhakti and then Jnana slowly and slowly. Atma Prabhude Hoti Hai. Atma Ki, Atma Ka Abhash Hota Hai. When that happens, Udetyanu Atma, so sabse uttam bhakti is, that's when it gets Uday. Uttam bhakti tab Uday hoti hai, aur tab kya hota hai? Bhagwat prem lakshana. So tab hum Bhagwat prem mein vilin ho jate hai, and that is the uttam bhakti, and that's what will lead us to really blissful state and also to Lord Krishna.
एक चीज और है गजानन प्रभु
हरे कृष्णा प्रभु
नाइन काइंड्स ऑफ डिवोशनल सर्विसेज देयर नौधा भक्ति शरणम कीर्तनम आत्मनिवर्तनम दास्यम साख्यम दैट इज टोल्ड बाय ध्रुव महाराज सो इट्स आल्सो शरणम कीर्तनम दास्यम साख्यम आत्मनिवर्तनम ये सब जो नौधा भक्ति में आता है तो श्रवण करते हैं कीर्तन करते हैं चैंटिंग करते हैं जब जो भी है मंदिर का मार्जन करते हैं धाम में यात्रा करते हैं दीज आर ऑल डिवोशनल सर्विसेज
राइट प्रभु जी थैंक यू सो मच या फॉर रिमाइंडिंग दैट लाइक वी रीड इन श्रीमद् भागवत गीता आल्सो राइट लाइक हाउ डू वी डू आवर डिवोशनल भक्ति सो स्टार्टिंग ऑल दीज एक्टिविटीज श्रवणम कीर्तनम Right, doing kirtan, listening to katha, doing chanting, and so on and so forth. So all those are our preliminary devotional activities, which will then take us to the real loving devotional activity. That will be like the love of the gopis. If we get deep into this, so that's gopis' love, Radharani's love, is that's the love, loving devotion for Lord Krishna. Right? That's why Lord Krishna sends Udhavji to Gopis to learn that really, if he really wanted to attain that supreme state, his knowledge was not enough. He had to really understand the Prem Bhakti from Gopis.
I think the word here is anxiously. So even if we are doing preliminary devotional activities, mm-hmm. We have to make sure that we are anxiously keeping. That means we are constantly thinking about the realized state that we need to reach. So that means, you know, that's the object of all endeavor that we're doing. So it's very important that not we do it with a purpose. to achieve the realized state of devotion.
So nice.
Sure.
Go to 5.61. धर्मान्यान परित्यज्य मामेकं भज विश्वसन् याद्रशी सदा सिद्धिर्भवति तादृशी कुर्व निरन्तरं कर्म लोको अयम् नु वर्तते तेनेव कर्मणा ध्यान माम परां भक्तिमिच्छति. सो सिंपली धर्मान्यान परित्यज्य, वी हैव ऑल हर्ड दिस, मामेकम भज विश्वशन, सब धर्म को परित्याग करके मेरी शरण में आ जाओ, मेरे विश्वास से भजन करो. यादृशी श्रद्धा, जैसे जैसे श्रद्धा बढ़ेगी सिद्धिर भवति तादृशी, वैसे वैसे सिद्धि होगी. कुर्व निरंतरम कर्म, जो निरंतर कर्म करते जा रहे हैं, कौन करते जा रहे हैं, लोको अयम नु वर्तते, लाइक इस संसार के लोग जो निरंतर कर्म करते जाएंगे, तेनेव कर्मणा ध्यान माम पराम भक्ति मिच्छति, उन कर्मों को करते हुए भी प्रेम भक्ति की तरफ आकर्षित होना चाहिए. सो दैट्स द मीनिंग ऑफ द श्लोक. जस्ट रीड द ट्रांसलेशन. प्रभु जी आप पढ़ेंगे ट्रांसलेशन.
Abandoning all meritorious performances, service me with faith. The realization will correspond to the nature of one's faith. The people of the world act successfully in pursuance of some ideal by meditating on me by means of those deeds on will obtain. Devotion characterized by love in the shape of the supreme service.
Ravi, padhoge?
Haan ji. The function characterized by unannoyed devotion is the real function of all individual soul, jivas. The other varieties of functions are activities of external cases. These extrinsic and esoteric dharma functions are manifold. Example, non-differential knowledge of Brahma aiming at extinctions of individuality. The Ashtanga Yoga Dharma having as its goal attainment of the state of exclusive existence. Kaivalya, atheistic protective ritualism aiming at the material enjoyment. Dhyana Yoga Dharma seeking to combine knowledge with fruitative activity and practice the function of barren asceticism.
Yeah. Ajay?
Hare Krishna.
Sure. Getting rid of all these, serve me by pure devotion, routed in faith. Exclusive faith in me is trust. Faith in the form of trust by the process of gradual purification tends to become a constant engagement. Nishtha, an object of liking. Ruchi of attainment, asakti, and a real sentiment, bhav. The more transparent the faith, the greater the degree of realization. If you ask how will the preservation and conduct of worldly affairs be feasible if one is continuously engaged in the endeavor for the realization of bhakti, what also will be the nature of the endeavor for the realization of bhakti when the body will perish consequent on the cessation of the function of the body and the society?
Thank you. Mukesh?
In order to strike at the root of this misgiving, the Supreme Lord says, this world subsists by the constant performance of certain activities. Fill all these activities with meditation of me. This will destroy the quality that makes those activities appear as acts done by you. They will then be of the nature of my service, bhakti. Mankind live by the threefold activities of the body, mind, and society. Eating, seating, walking, resting, sleeping, cleansing the body, covering the body, etc. are the various bodily activities, thinking, recollecting, retaining an impression, becoming aware of an entity.
Can read up to here.
Entity, feeling pressure and pain, etc. are the mental feats. Marrying, practicing reciprocal relationship between the king and the subject, practicing brotherhood, attending at sacrificial meetings, offering oblations, digging wells, tanks, etc. for the benefit of the people, maintaining one's relations, practicing hospitality, observing proper civic conduct, showing due respect to other are the various social activities.
When these acts are performed for one's selfish enjoyment, they are called karma kand. When the desire for attainment of freedom from activity by knowledge underlines these actions, they are termed gyan yog or karma yog. And when these activities are engaged to perform this way, that is conducive to our endeavor for attainment of bhakti, they are called gyan bhakti yog, the subsidiary devotional practices. But only those activities that are characterized by the principle of pure worship are called bhakti, bhakti proper. My meditation is practiced in every act. When bhakti proper is practiced in due time, while performing the subsidiary devotional activities in one's intercourse with the ungodly people of the world.
In such position, a jiva does not become apathetic to Godhead even by performing those worldly activities. This constitutes the practice of looking inwards, which is turning towards one's real self. Video is Upanishad. Void is Upanishad. Or vide in. Yeah. Isavasyam idam sarvam yat kincha jagatyam jagat tena tyaktena bunjita ma grada kasya savim dhyanam dhanyam. Iso mantra 1. The commentator says in regards to this, tena isa tyaktena visrastena, the real significance being that if whatever is accepted be received as favor vouchsafed by the Supreme Lord, the worldly activity will cease to be such and will turn into service of Godhead, bhakti. So Isvasya says, kurvan eva karmani, karma lipyate nare.
Yeah, this is a long purport. We'll continue reading. Ravi?
Yes. If the worldly acts as are performed in the above manner, one does not get entangled in the karma, even in the hundreds of years of worldly life. The meaning of these two mantras from the Jina point of view is renouncement of the fruits of one's worldly action. But from the bhakti point of view, they mean the attainment of Krishna favor, prasadam, by their transfer of his account. In this method, which is the path of archana, you should do your duties of the world by meditation of worshipping God ahead thereby. Brahma cherishes the desire for creation in his heart.
Okay.
Hare Krishna.
If that creative desire is practiced by the same with the meditation of obeying there in the command of the Supreme Lord, then it will be a subsidiary spiritual function. Gyan Dharma, being helpful for the growth of the disposition for the service of the divinity by reason of its characteristic of seeking the production of Godhead. It was certainly proper to instruct Brahma in this manner. There is no occasion for such instruction in case of a jiva in whom the spontaneous aversion for entities other than Krishna manifests itself on his attainment of the substantive entity of spiritual devotion, bhav. Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna. So this is really a long purport, but I think let's read the next shloka, which is the final shloka of Brahma Samhita, and then if we have time, we can discuss. Otherwise, we can continue discussing tomorrow on this. But let's read the final shloka. Yes, Prabhuji.
Gajanan Prabhu. Yes. Oh, shloka jara dikhai na wapas. Ek second. Wala 61 English Hindi mein. So original text Hindi wala jo dikha rahe the na.
ये ना
हाँ हाँ देखिए इसमें ना धर्मान परित्यज्य 18.66 भगवद गीता में देखिए उसमें भगवान बोलते हैं सर्वधर्मान परित्यज्य सिमिलर वर्ड है वही बताना चाहता था ठीक है आगे बढ़िए
दास सही है 18.66
सेम श्लोक ही कल सुन
ओके
सर्वधर्मान परित्यज माम एकम शरणम भ्रज भज यहाँ भी बोलते हैं धर्मान परित्यज माम एकम भज विश्व विश्व
संघ
हाँ पढ़िए लास्ट
श्लोक मोर ऑन दैट टुमारो मे बी वी हैव 3 मिनट्स लेट्स सी इफ वी कैन कंप्लीट द फाइनल श्लोक टुडे सो अहम हि विश्वस्य चराचरस्य बीजं प्रधानं प्रकृतिः पुमांश्च मया हितं तेज इदं विभर्षि So very quickly what it says is Aham hi visvasya chara charasya. So yeah, Brahman pura main hi chala raha hun. Main hi bijam pradhanam. I am the root of that. I am the pradhan of that. I am prakriti. I am purush. Maya hitam tej idam vibharshi vidhe. So vidhe is addressing to Lord Brahma. Vidhe vidhe. Ye jo tej aapke andar विभर्षि जो उभर रहा है दैट इज माई दैट इज गिवन बाई मी मया आहितम तेज इदम विभर्षि विदे विदे ही त्वम अथो जगंती उस तेज को लेकर अब आप सृष्टि की रचना कीजिए सो दैट इज व्हाट लॉर्ड कृष्णा इज सेइंग सो लेट्स रीड द ट्रांसलेशन हाँ मुकेश वांट टू रीड ट्रांसलेशन
Listen, Ovidi, I am the seed. That is the fundamental principle of this world of animate and inanimate objects. I am Pradhan, the substance of the matter. I am Prakriti, material cause, and I am Purusha, efficient cause. This fiery energy that belongs specially to Brahma that inherits in you has also been conferred by me. It is by bearing this fiery energy that you regulate this phenomenal world of animate and inanimate objects.
Yeah, I think this purport also is a little longer and we only have 1 minute left. I think we'll have to defer it to tomorrow. So we'll complete Brahma Samhita tomorrow. Okay. Let's play the final kirtan for 1 minute and then we will meet tomorrow again. I'll take a picture. Okay.
Shine. Shanti.